So we're off to get another Suburban.
This one's pretty local. It's only, what, 10 minutes down the road?
10 minutes down the road.
Just an accident. It just happened to see it.
Driving by and saw it. It's our own backyard. We can't let one go by when it's our own backyard.
This will be number 20. We're in the 20s, right?
Yeah, 23, I think. Do we count the two that don't run? Because we may be 24, 25 if we count the ones we don't run.
Well, if they're not carcasses, then I guess we count them.
Okay, I got one carcass and the rest of them. And we only have one, really, that ST16. That's probably the only one that won't start, that we haven't tried.
That one may need a motor. Yeah. But I mean, it's all there. It just needs the motor. So this one, it's got a plow, it's got weights, chains, it runs, it starts, it moves,
and it's our backyard. You just can't drive by.
No.
Even if you're not looking for them, you can't drive by, see one out in front that's right down the street and not inquire about it.
No, I just did a double take, you know. It just caught me off guard. I would never expect a 40-year-old tractor. The ones that we enjoy, I mean, just sit right out there in the yard. But then look at your next-door neighbor had that one right there.
Yeah, well, he came over and asked me. Yeah, he asked if I wanted it.
Well, I think you paid a whole, $35 for that one?
$40. It was $60 because it had a good battery.
Oh, that's right.
40 without the battery. And of course, we ran it that day, got the mouse nest out of it, and it's been sitting ever since.
Yeah, we haven't gotten to that one. We need to, and what I like about that one is the grill.
Yeah.
I like those horizontal, that horizontal look in the front with those, the way it's slotted like that. That's cool.
Well, the custom, each letter is like a child's block. You know?
Right, like a play block.
Play block, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. You know, I'm not sure what year this one is. It could be a 71 or 72. But if it's a 71, we'll have every one from 66 to 73.
Well,
every single year.
Well, the very first one that I have, you know, that I painted that dark blue.
Right.
That's a 71. I just don't have a 71 hood on it.
Oh, okay.
Because it was in a fire. Fire before I had it. And I went and I saw a 68 sitting in a field. And I couldn't get it out of the mud. So I bought it. But I just took the hood and the grill. And I don't even remember what it looked like, right? Because back then I didn't know I was going to be buying a couple of these. So I threw the grill out. I don't know if it could have been fixed. I don't remember how bad it was. I just remember it was kind of messed up where the hood didn't go up and down very easily. And that's gone. I wish I hadn't thrown it out.
Did you check the year on that yellow one? The last one that we got? Is that a 74 or 75? Or?
I did, and I don't remember. I think 73, but...
No, because it's got the flat dash. It doesn't have that concave dash. So that's probably...
The 16.6?
Yes.
I think that's...
That's probably
75 or 76 because okay. Those red knobs.
That's right.
So
technically, we have everything from 66 to 73. 66 was the first year for the Suburban.
Well, the Custom 6 is a 65, is it not?
64, 65, yeah.
So, maybe. And I sold the Onan Twin, that's 76 I had. I think it was a 76.
Did it have the concave dash or the flat dash?
The Twin. The Onan Twin? I don't remember.
I think it had the flat dash. Yeah, because it had the tank. The gas tank was under the seat. So I think that's mid to late 70s. So.
Yeah, I think it was 76 if I recall, or 77.
See, we're gonna have to do an update video. I think that count may be wrong. You know.
Yeah, it's pretty pathetic, you can't even count them. It's too hard to think of them all. I mean, I'm not even sure what you have. You've taken a couple and swapped some pieces apart. So I don't know what you got left there. Your 67s and 68 SSs, you know, those...
Yeah, they're kind of Frankenstein.
Yeah.
Different. Right. I mean, all the pieces are still there. It's just a matter of... I wanted to get... You know, I was excited because I got a new one, and then I wanted to get something running and actually move with it. So I'd take an engine out of this and give it to that and make it run, which, by the way, we still have extra motors. We could get that 16 ST16 running any day. It's just a matter of finding the time to swap the motor and...
Well, I only have 10s and 12s, though. It's to the right, right?
Yeah, you made
yeah,
it right.
Yeah, I saw this thing when I was on my way up
so
north.
So you have seen it before?
It was in the garage.
Did you think about inquiring about it?
Yes, I told my wife. I says, there's a Suburban in there. We got to go where we got to be. We can't stop. Oh, come on. So I didn't stop. And then, of course, I didn't remember which house it was. But, you know, the door was open when we went by the first time when we came back from where we were at.
That's what I just asked him. I said, I don't remember which house it was. Because he said, well, I'll have the door open. Because I couldn't remember. It was right here on the left somewhere.
I'm not sure if he'll let us film. I'm sure he won't mind, but...
Well, I don't think... Yeah.
I'll just roll up with it, Rowan. Is that it?
No. He had like a... You know, that's the thing. I think he said 555 or something.
This
the address.
This thing's gonna be over a 10-minute video. Better hurry up and get up there. There he is. Back up in the middle of the road. So yeah, I love that grill. That's the ghost grill. You can't see it, but oh yeah.
Do you know what year that is? Is it like a 71, 72?
Somewhere right around there, yeah.
Is it?
Okay.
I'm thinking maybe we need to get the plow off.
Yeah, well, let's take the plow off so we don't gotta fool with it. And
then load it up.
Load it up, okay. I don't know, that engine looks a little different. I have to look at it's, that in the barn at home.
It's got the 143 number, it's gotta be Tecumseh.
Yeah.
But it's got like the different style.
Totally different.
It's got the same engine block as your 70. If you look at your 70, I'm sure it's got, you'll notice it's the same engine. So I'm almost certain it's Tecumseh. So what do you think?
Oh, that's a steal, dude.
I gave you two great deals already. The 69 SS, which has got a mint body. That's a low mileage, super clean paint original. And then the yellow one. I turned you on to that one, which I think was a good deal too. Those both were good mowers.
That's nice.
But this $400-$600 stuff is just, you know, it's too much.
Well, I mean, some of the prices, what was the thing I pointed out to you? What did that guy want? On a common part, $80 on something that should have been, you know, a few bucks. What was that part?
It was a hood brace from a dash to the grill. That center support.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I got dozens of them. And he's asking $70 for that thing.
A steering wheel for an ST was $80.
That's a little bit more easier to swallow than that hood bracket, you know, that goes...
I would never pay $80, $70 for a part when... I mean, this is a perfect example, you know... A little bit more, you get the whole deal. I mean, you know, the hood braces don't really go bad. You know what I'm saying?
No.
It's not a very desirable part.
A tree fell on it, or they took it apart and lost it, but they just don't. they don't go bad, right?
Or people will sell like those toolboxes under the seat. You know, you just, you don't need those replaced.
Yeah.
I mean, unless they're always there.
Unless you want to convert, because I bought those foot pegs that go around the you know, the old 67s, you know, they have that short footbed.
Right.
And you know, I just want to swap it out because I like that the footrest to go all the way back to the rear fender.
Well, I don't know how all this got out of control, but this 99 cent starting bid prices, like on eBay and stuff, is gone. You know, people put buy it now prices $30 apart, $40 apart, $80 apart. I mean, it just,
there's like there's some entity out there driving the prices up because, you know,
yeah,
making
you.
Them popular.
Us. Making everything popular, that's right. No.
Well, every day, or every other day, there must be at least one Suburban out there that's getting parted out. So,
yeah, that's
there's less and less of them out there, and I just cannot part one out. I mean, I know I can make money. I just cannot. I can't pull myself to do it. I guess if I was on hard times and or did that for a living, but
maybe that's just what makes them more desirable. They're just getting harder to find.
If, and then you go down the road and they're sitting out there with a for sale sign. We're getting this one. Around us that snatch them up. A week later, you see them on eBay. Every part that was there, and you knew that was the one that was for sale.
Oh, without a doubt.
Just sickening. Of course, that person's pretty nice. I bought a couple parts from them, but.
Well, if that was on Craigslist or eBay, I'm sure it would have got picked off as soon as it went up, especially for that price. But that's all he really said.
Well, it's safe now. It will be safe in the kingdom of Suburbans.
That's right.
No one will tear that one apart. The metal on it looks great. I mean, he repainted it, but I think it's not close enough to the teal blue. But it looks like it would be easy to redo.
The nice thing about it, I mean, it's all there. It hasn't been... I mean, there's a replacement motor on it, which I'm going to get the numbers, and we'll have to find out what year that is. And but it, you know, having all those pieces there and to see it actually run is a big thing. You know, how many have we picked off that didn't actually run?
All right, here we are.
And back at the headquarters.
Check it out, they're open for business.
Hey, we're in luck.
Oh yeah.
All right, we got a new delivery. SSBTC is open for business. That looks pretty good. All right, you're good. Could it be? Could it be? Yes, it is. All right, let's get her down.